Thank you and welcome to our Sojourn concert. This group is still in paradise, and it's made up of obviously adults, not saying they're older or anything. Some are. We've been playing since about April 1st, and actually this group has actually played down in Moxie's twice now, I think, and probably we may do that in the future also, but if you don't know anything about the steel drum world, we have different kinds of steel drums, and the smaller steel drums in the front here play all of the higher melodies. The double seconds right here play similar to that, and then we have the double guitars, those three over there, different colors, chromed, blue, yellow, doesn't matter, it's still the same instrument. And you can hear on that song, they actually played the melody a little bit on the second stanza, so I try to write these songs so that everybody gets to play the melody at least a little bit. And then, of course, we have our bass player, Shirley, back there, who plays all six of those massive drums. And she's the best bass player in this group. So, I'm going to hear about that later. This next one's the steel drummer boy. I kind of made a different sort of feel to this, so it's not just your standard little drummer boy. This is sort of steel drum-ish, and it's got a little bit of a Caribbean beat to it, so I hope you enjoy it. Spice was written about 12 or 13 years ago, and I've heard it described, this isn't a Christmas song by the way, but I've heard it described as music that you would hear if you were playing a video game by some of the kids that have played it, so keep that in mind, I guess. Also in the middle, there's sort of a round that's going to happen. It's going to start with the bass and the guitars start, and you'll hear the round that starts, and this is one of the more difficult ones, so I think you would agree this is a little bit more difficult, and we've had a lot of fun working on this Urban Spice.
Thank you.
Tuned in such a way that if you bump or anything, well, if you fall down the stairs, you're going to be in trouble. So I thought, well, how am I going to do this? Now, remember, my tuner lives in Austin, Texas. So, and I just got back from there the weekend before, having drums tuned. So I wasn't real happy with whoever did. Okay, it was my fault. But so I remember the tuner telling me, sometimes, you know, if the drum is really damaged, you can pull on it, like pull on the rim, and it'll, like popping your back, it'll put everything back into a tune, which I thought, what the odds that's going to happen to me? But so I said, okay, well, I'm going to try it because I'm going to Austin anyway. Might as well try it. I grabbed the drum, and I put my foot on one side of the rim, and I pulled up on the other side, and I thought I hurt my back wrench. But what really happened was the drum went, and it went right back into tune. We now call that the miracle at Mem Hall. I call it that, I don't know. But people ask me, well, how do you tune these drums anyway? I mean, how does that work? And what really happens is they take a hammer and they hit on the inside of these. Joseph, could you tilt yours without messing up the lights? You can see on the inside that there's kind of like different areas to play. And Joseph, could you play one? That was unbelievably good. He's a pro, though, so, yeah. But you can see that there's different places to, every one of those indentations is a different note, and they tune those by hitting those notes with a hammer and shaking that bubble. That's how it is. It's a long process, but basically, they go out of tune in two ways. If you're playing in direct sunlight, the sun will change the metal a little bit, and it'll go slightly out of tune. Or if you happen to be dropping it somewhere, it'll actually hurt it also. So that was that story. Let's see. We're going to play our version of Jingle Bells. And again, this has a little bit of a different beat to it. It's called a soca beat. It's sol and calypso put together called soca. So we're going to finish up. This is an original song called Blue Samba.
Thank you.
me ask you, how many of you were in the band last year? How many are veterans of this group? So how many, okay, how many are new then? Raise your hand like this. There we go. So you can see we have quite half the band is new, and so that means that they had to start in August or a little bit later. So they've really only been playing, you know, 2 or 3 months, and that's asking a lot for people to learn new instruments and play at a level that's pretty, that hangs in with everybody else. So really proud of the level that we've been able to achieve. And that was the easiest song, so it's going to go up from there, just so you know. Let's see, I think this is Do You Hear,
correct?
This is an arrangement of Do You Hear What I Hear, and this is, it's just one long crescendo. I've said it 1,000 times. This song that I arranged is supposed to start soft, and by the end, if you know the song, the king is saying, listen to this, you know what I say. So at the end, it gets very majestic, just so you know what's going on. It starts very gentle, and then the guitars, and the second save over the melody, and then it goes on from there. So it's wonderful arranging. It's beautiful. Yes. So I keep convincing them they just won't go with me.
Thank you.
one, it's customary here at Bethel College to take a funeral offering, which we'll do. And part of the reason I want to tell you that is because there are some CDs over here that are not this group. They're actually some of my CDs. And I just wanted to offer them to you. If you want to take one home with you, take one. And just if you want to take some silver music home, that would be great. And what that is just me and my family band playing. And that is, I just want to make it clear, that's not the script. We're going to make a CD. We haven't done it yet. But if you want one of those, be my guest and just take one. But also, part of the expenses that go with this is that, as I spoke to you about, the tuning is it's very cheap to get these tuned. In fact, it's $150 a drum. It's not cheap. Take that back. But also, we have to go all the way to Austin to do that. So we don't like to do that, but if you can help us a little bit, that would be terrific. It offsets some of the cost of putting on this program. And we are going to do the Lord Bless You and Keep You, which is a complete departure from what we have been doing. This is done as a chorale. And this is, believe it or not, one of the most musical and difficult things we're doing. In order to play smooth and roll-like on these drums and make it chorale-like, it's very difficult because you have to switch drums. It's not like singing where you can just make that smooth sound. So that's what we're going to attempt. Christmas probably is the way you've heard this. Again, I like to put things in a calypso kind of island sort of beat, and this is no exception. Thank you. ready to go. But I have some housekeeping to do first. I want to thank Judy Walter back there for allowing this drum right here is hers. I borrowed it from her because we had an extra player that we needed to put on the drum. So thank you, Judy, for letting us do that. Yes. And my son Colin is doing the video tonight. He's in the plaid shirt right there. Did you have one? And just to let you know, these students here do such a great job, but they do a lot here at Bethel College. And there's kids here, and the vast majority of kids are involved in things like the choir, Woven, am I right? Or Woven Road? Yes. And we have an athlete, and we have just people that do various things. So you'll see them also. The vast majority of these kids are also in Threshold, which is the pet band. So they're very busy, and they have, of course, their own thing going on in their own life. So really appreciate their time in adding to this. And it was such a great job. They worked very hard on this music, so really. I personally think we saved the most difficult for last. And we were hoping that somebody might yell encore, because if we didn't, that would be depressing. So we did an arrangement of Sleigh Ride. I want to tell you that it's an abridged version, which means it's not the whole Sleigh Ride, but we're going to do that for you. And I also want to let you know that if you want to see the drums up close, feel free to do that and look at them and just see what they're doing. I invite you to do that. And I want to thank you guys for coming out tonight, because it's so fun to play for empty chairs. But thank you guys for making an effort to be here tonight. So thank you. Thank you again for coming. We have a great holiday season. Merry Christmas, and safe drive home.